Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. In the last lecture, we have studied that what is the relation between the molar conductivity and the conductivity of a particular solution. So based on that, we are going to solve a numerical and let us see how can we solve it. So as present on your screen, there is a question which is based on molar conductivity and conductivity of a particular solution. So it says, the conductivity of a 0.20 molar solution of KCl at 298 Kelvin is 0.0248 Siemens per centimeter. So calculate its molar conductivity. So the thing that we have to do, the first one is we have to extract the data from the given question. So based on this thing, I could say that this 0.20 molar is nothing but the concentration that they have provided to us. Now, this temperature has no role in the formula, so therefore no consideration is given to this temperature for this instance. And talking about this 0.0248 Siemens per centimeter is nothing but the conductivity that they have provided. So now, based on these two things, we have to calculate the molar conductivity. It is very much simple. So let us first of all write out what are the given data present in the solution or present in the question. The given data says that the concentration is nothing but 0.20 molar, while that of conductivity, that is K, is given as 0.0248 Siemens centimeter, which can be also written as ohm inverse centimeter inverse. So now we have a relation or we have a formula that capital lambda is equals to K, that is kappa, into 1000 divided by C. So for this instance, the value of K is given as 0.0248 into 1000 divided by C, in this case is 0.20. So if we calculate this thing, we could get, so after calculating that, we have got the value of lambda, that is the molar conductivity, as 1.24. But what would be the unit of this molar conductivity? The unit of this molar conductivity will be nothing but ohm inverse centimeter square mole inverse. This is the unit of molar conductivity that we have initially derived in the definitions also. So this is how we have calculated the molar conductivity. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got to know that this was a very simple numerical that you could solve. And for more related to this, so we are going to make more numericals so that you could solve it again based on this kind of numericals or this kind of formulas. So share this video with your friends and don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.